than the creek, and he set his heart on Daniel to deliver him. Then he thought, I'll get him delivered. But he labored till the going down of the sun to deliver him. Then these men assembled unto the king and said to the king, Know, O king, that the law of the Medes and Persians is, that no decree nor statute which the king established may be changed. Then the king commanded, and they brought Daniel and cast him into the den of lions. Now the king spake and said unto Daniel, Thy God whom thou servest continually, say continually. You see, he knew that Daniel served God continually. And so he said, The God that you serve continually, he will deliver me. Now Nebuchadnezzar, to the three Hebrew children, he said, Who is this God that can deliver you out of my hands? They said, Our God is almighty. If you throw us in the fire, he shall deliver us. That
is. Yes.
But now the king's saying, Now he had known about the story about the three Hebrew children, same God. So he said, Your God will deliver you. Because he knew about God. He knew who he delivered. So he said, The God that you serve continually, he will deliver you. And the stone was brought and laid upon the mouth of the den, and the king filled it with his own signets. They had like ring signets that they put wax on and sealed, and they sealed it. And with the signet of his lord, that the purpose might not be changed concerning. So he locked him in the lion's den and put a stone over it. Then the king went to his palace and passed the night fasting. Neither were there any instruments of music brought before him, and his sleep went from him. He couldn't sleep all night. Then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste unto the den of lions. And when he came to the den, he cried with a lamentable voice unto them. Now he was thinking, now even though he said, Your God will deliver you, he was still like worried about it.
Mm-hmm.
He was thinking, he may not have survived the night. So he went with sorrow. And he spake and said, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thy God, whom thou servest continually, able to deliver thee from the lions?
Thank
you. He'd been there all night with the lions. Then Daniel said unto the king, O king, live forever. My God hath sent his angel and hath shut the lion's mouth. The Bible says the angel of the Lord is encamped round about those who fear him,
yes,
and they're there to deliver them. Praise be, Father. The angel of the Lord is encamped round about you when you serve God, and they're there to deliver you. Praise be, Father. As long as you're faithful to God, God will be faithful to you.
Amen.
God will honor you when you honor God. Praise be, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Daniel says, The angel has shut the lion's mouth, and they have not hurt me. For as much as before him innocently was found in me, and also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt. He said, I have not done anything wrong. God found me innocent, and so he has spared my. He sent his angels, and they shut the lion's mouth. And then the king was exceedingly glad for him, and commanded that they should take up Daniel out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found upon him, because he believed in his God. He had faith
in God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Because he had faith in God. The lions could not hurt him. You understand? The fire cannot hurt you if you have faith in God. The lions cannot hurt you if you have faith in God. The mountains cannot fall on you if you have faith in God. If you have faith in God, you can move the mountains by faith.
Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah. Glory.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Glory to God.
So then King Darius wrote unto all the people, nations, and languages that dwell in the earth. I skipped some. And then the king commanded that they brought those men which had accused Daniel, and they cast them into the den of lions, them, their children, and their wives. And the lions had the mastery of them, and break all their bones in pieces, or ever they came at the bottom. Notice, before they hit the bottom of the den, the lions had torn to pieces.
Yeah.
Not only the men, but their whole families. Had destroyed them, had broke their bones to pieces.
That's what you did. That's what the lions do. My battery's down?
Yep.
Give me some new batteries. Thank you, Father. We're taking an intermission here.
That's right. Hallelujah.
Brief intermission. Yes, it is.
Thank you, Father. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done.
He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. Thank you, Lord.
I want to praise His name. I'll never be the same. I'm going to praise Him. Look what the Lord has done.
Praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
So then, King Darius wrote unto all the people, nations, and language that dwell in all the earth, peace be multiplied unto you. I make a decree that in every dominion of my kingdom, men tremble and fear before the God of Daniel. Notice, just like Nebuchadnezzar, he commanded the people to serve the God of Ben, which is the God we serve.
Yes. Almighty thank you, God. Lord. Yes.
The only living God.
Yes.
The rest of God's are dead.
Yes.
You know, people serve Buddha. You know what Buddha is in the grave?
Thank you.
People serve all kinds of the men, but they're in the grave. Jesus came out of the grave.
Yes.
And He's alive today. Yes. He's living today. Yes. Glory to God. He is here to strengthen you. He is here to help you. He is here to deliver you.
Yes.
Praise you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God.
In every dominion of my kingdom, men tremble and fear before the God of Daniel. For He is the living God and steadfast forever. And that's true. He was speaking the truth. God has never changed. He's the same yesterday. He's the same today.
Thank you, Lord.
He's the same forever. He's steadfast.
Yes.
Unmovable.
Thank you.
Praise you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Unchangeable. And He is almighty. Thank you, Father.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise.
Thank you, Lord. And His kingdom shall not be destroyed, nor His dominion shall ever unto the end. He will always be the same. He is Almighty God.
Yes, Lord.
And He delivered and rescued, and He worketh signs and wonders in heaven and in earth, who hath delivered Daniel from the power of the lion. So this Daniel prospered in the reign of Darius and in the reign of Cyrus the Persian. God blessed him. You know, he was faithful to God. God not only spared him from the lions, but then when he went through the lion's den, He promoted him.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
He prospered in the kingdom.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory.
If you are faithful to God, He'll be faithful to you.
Yes.
If you can trust God, if you can believe God, if you can put your faith in God, He'll see you through the fire. He'll see you through the storm. He'll help you through those times of hard times in your life. He'll strengthen you. He'll cause you to be triumphant. He'll cause the world to stare at you and say, man, they must have something going there with God.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
He is Almighty God. Speak the word with me.
Thank you, Lord.
Say this, I can do all things.
I can do all things.
Through Christ. The greater one is in me.
I'm the head and not the tail.
I'm above and not below.
Everything I put my hand
to prosper and is blessed. I am blessed.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God. Amazing grace.